You know, you got some people want quantity. They want a whole bunch of bullshit. Give me a whole little of some good shit.
Failblock.com. Got your boy Squirrel in the building. Coming to my favorite restaurant, the Bay Area, Jack Leather Square. I'm at Edwards and Jones. The best barbecue in the Bay Area, hands down. You know what I mean? They got the stiffest margaritas in America right there. You know what I mean? See Obama on the stove. Get that good cookie. Get that stove over there with Obama.
Syrup Nation's my clan. Apparel ridiculous, high siding in the Jeep with the Merrill, so conspicuous. Fly birds down south, them wing stops, dumping pig wings. Sip of syrup, pimp the
purple. Then you go with this right here, you know what I'm saying? Fote gave me some peanut butter and jelly and a loaf of bread. He said, Squirrel, go make a sandwich, Squirrel. Squirrel made a sandwich, lunch, dinner, and a sandwich. You know what I mean? Best barbecue in America. Yeah, we at Edwards and Jones, right downstairs from the legendary Up All Night Studios. Yeah, I've been up in that place up in there, the Short Dog Studios.
Could I get, I guess, the rib, like a personal rib plate?
The Bay don't get its just due in the hip-hop world. We contributed a lot to the hip-hop world. Player hater, Captain Save 'em, you a hater. You know, they all in New York calling each other player haters now. That started out here. Now, I don't got nothing bad to say about the hyphy movement, but I thought we was finna break out with the hyphy movement, but it didn't do like I thought it would. Even with the help of Lil Jon, you know, I just thought we was on our way to Mars. I'm trying to buy me some real estate on the moon. And it didn't bust out like that, man. It didn't happen. So, you know, Keep the Sneak and Mr. Fab, everybody was pushing hard. The only thing I can see is it was some corporate janky shit going on behind closed doors. You know what I'm saying? It's like, it seemed like ever since Pac died, there's been a conspiracy to keep California out of the game. Literally. Come on, man. Somebody got to be in that corporate office saying, we don't not want the Bay Area to ever make it again. What we had on the West Coast, we was cool, we partied, but we did the gangster boogie. You know, the gang banging, the gangster boogie, the drive-by shootings, and people got tired of that shit. They don't want the party shot up every time they come to the party. They shoot the party up. We can't come to the party because they're going to shoot the party up. So the party moved to the south.
Rims, brand new whips, like Pringles,
Lord have mercy.
Chips,
turn Al Boo-Boo out on the greatest barbecue in the Bay Area, man. Chips. You know what I mean? We in Jack London. Just taste that sauce.
It's spicy, man. It is good.
But y'all need to send y'all some type of little Russian spy or something up in here. Do some espionage and figure out what they using to make they sauce with. Boy, it's awesome.
They all begin to talk shit about Squirrel. He let those rims twirl. I'm from Hollister, nigga. I'll knock your girl.
That's an old school jar, right? My grandmama used to have these at the house. These are like old school jelly jars. Back in the day, we used to be cooking with these. Y'all know what I mean. When I say cook with these, at first I should just be happy. Go to the studio, make a song, and just put it on CD, and now I got a song. I'm thinking, oh, I can go press it up and put it out. Nah, it's steps to making an album. TC produced my whole album. He helped me find myself as far as I have an identity. Squirrel, it's a lot of artists out there that don't have identities. Because you're trying to sound like him this week, then you're trying to sound like Gucci Man next week, then you want to be Jeezy today. Squirrel has always been Squirrel. I had a 100 proof album that I recorded with them, which was like in the 90s. The group, everybody went their own ways when Solo did what they did. And I was fortunate to be blessed to hook up with Fote, which was a household name that, you know, he, like I say, he gave me a loaf of bread, some peanut butter and jelly, and told me how to make a sandwich. You know what I'm saying? I learned a lot from that guy. And, you know, I had a solid relationship with Fote, and that's my partner, man. I can call on him. Fote is cool, man, you know. He worked with everybody from Tupac to Cash Money The boy got plaques up the ass.
I got a hoe named Real Derrill. She got a buddy named SB12. Now you know the deal. We gets freaky in the studio late night. That's why the beats that you hear coming real tight. Something to roll to, something to stroll to. If
you supply, you know, I done cried to him about my problems. He done cried to me about his problems. So dude's a solid dude, man. The actual album was supposed to be called Off the Meat Rack, because everybody was talking about off the hook this, off the hook that. So I'm like, you know what, we off the meat rack. And me and folks, we start hanging with each other now. So we going through different hoods, and everybody, hey, when they see us, Ghetto Viz it is.
I can't help you, bit me. Got a Mac and degree, me and my homies, we sucker for a year. Living the life.
A long time ago, man, I was hustling, and I was in a tree. I was in a tree for real. I was in a tree, and the customers used to come through. The police used to be out. I was in a real bushy tree, and the customers used to come through, and I'd be hid up in the tree. When they come through, they look up and tell me what they want. They throw their money up. I drop their stuff down out the tree. And one time, my friend father came through. He said, he looked up, and he called me Squirrel. It'd been at least 20. I've been Squirrel for about 20. Damn. So you know, you got Secret Squirrel, the cartoon. You got Boo Wink on the Rocky the Squirrel show. You know what I'm saying? Got this good old Everton Jones in front of me. I think I'm gonna wrap this up and take this home with me, man, because this better than some OG Kush wrapped in a Swisher Sweet, man. You dig? They said this is the raggediest bridge in California. That's why the motherfucker broke when the 89 earthquake was hit. Well, imagine having to take a boo boo and a potty pop, a porta potty at the top of that thing up there, and it's windy as hell.
You think they have a porta potty up there?
Man, I seen one up there one day we were driving by. That's what made me even think about it. Look, where is that? I can't see it. I'm driving.
Right.
See it? Can you imagine sitting in the porta potty? And by you being up high, you know it's high wind.